Gotta look out for this dog, because I think he... Yep, yes. Hey guys, it's Adam, aka Swimming Bird, and welcome to The Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask 3D for the Nintendo 3DS. This is an enhanced remake of the N64 game from 2000, which is one of the most divisive Zelda games among fans, but it also happens to be my favorite, so I'm excited to play this one with you guys. If you've never tried out Majora, or you just want to see the changes and improvements for the 3D version, either way, you're invited to watch along as we complete the game 100% and hopefully stop the apocalypse. Okay, so we're gonna start with a little bit of story here. In the land of Hyrule, there echoes a legend held dearly by the royal family that tells of a boy. A boy who, after battling evil and saving Hyrule, crept away from the land that had made him a legend. Done with the battles he once waged across time, he embarked on a journey, a secret and personal journey, a journey in search of a beloved and invaluable friend. Someone familiar, a friend with whom he parted ways when he finally fulfilled his heroic destiny and took his place among legends. And that sound brings me back. So, this game is actually a direct sequel to Ocarina of Time on the N64, but even if you haven't played Ocarina of Time before, it doesn't matter, you can get into Majora's Mask. It's a very separate world, very different from Hyrule. It's dark, creepy, and really unique, actually. A lot of the characters are very interesting, and that's just one of the reasons why it's my favorite in the Zelda series. So we're starting things out pretty differently here. We have a very sad Link riding through the forest. He looks defeated, he can't find his friend, and he's riding on his little horse, Epona, and a couple of fairies are peeping on us, but that's alright. What can fairies do to a little boy with a sword and a shield and an awesome little horse? I don't think we're in any danger here. We're just gonna, you know, keep waltzing around looking for our buddy. Uh-oh, fairy attack. Oh, jeez. Yeah, Epona is a little afraid of them, but then she just kind of stands there after Link gets thrown off. She doesn't show any concern, even though Link's, like, knocked out. So here is probably my favorite villain in the series. It's the Skull Kid, and he's looking awesome there with his mysterious mask. Hee hee. You two fairies did great. I wonder if he has anything good on him. Huh? This guy. Well, that shouldn't be a problem. He's creeping all up. So the Skull Kid's body is, like, made out of wood. It's supposed to be little children that get lost in the forest. The legend says they turn into Skull Kids. So you don't want to get lost out in the forest. You get a pretty awesome costume, though. And sometimes you can find a cool mask. Oh, he just stole my ocarina. All right.
Ooh, what a pretty ocarina. Hey, Skull Kid, let me touch it. I want to see.
I love how he plays it and laughs.
You can't, Tail. What would we do if you dropped it and broke it? No way. You can't touch it.
You're not old enough.
But sis, why can't I try it out, too?
Do fairies have mouths? They must. Somewhere in that glowy orb of light, there's got to be a little face in there. Aw. He's just having fun with Ocarina. He didn't steal anything. That's his Ocarina of Time that he found. Well, in for a penny, in for a pound. He's gonna steal the horse as well. This guy's just starting a life of crime early on. And we got this cool action scene. Link really should have had a saddle. He probably could have grabbed onto that. Maybe he wouldn't have fallen off Epona in the first place if he actually had a tiny little cute pony saddle. But we're gonna get started here and get control of Link in a second. And then we can journey to this new land. Whoa, there we go. Alright, Link's just getting tossed around. This, like I mentioned, it's a very different world from most Zelda games. You start out kind of being kicked down into the dirt, and it's only going to get a little worse for Link from here, but it's going to get exciting as we go. So I've got my little sword and shield combo here. We can do all the standard Zelda stuff, spin attacks, rolls. Of course, if you're speedrunning, you got to roll everywhere, but I'm not going to do that necessarily. Here's a little sign. You may already know this, but here's a quick review of the basic controls. This is telling us how to move around and use our sword and jump. The first thing I noticed about this game when I played is that when you jump, sometimes Link will do crazy, yeah, he does all these, like, crazy tricks that he didn't do in Ocarina. So they definitely souped up his little jump animation. All right, here we go. Alice in Wonderland style, down into this creepy pit. And things are gonna get more and more creepy as we go. Whoa. This reminds me of Rainbow Road in Mario Kart 64. We got all these cool little images here glowing. And this game looks great. I haven't played in quite a while, and it definitely improves the looks of Majora's Mask a lot. having it on the 3DS. Oh, so cool. You can just, like, float in the air and do creepy head jiggles.
What's with that stupid horse of yours? It doesn't listen to a word that's said to it.
It's just a horse, man. Come on. Give it a break.
There's no point in riding a thing like that, so I did you a favor and got rid of it. Hee hee. Aw, boo-hoo. Why the sad face? I just thought I'd have a little fun with you. Oh, come on. Do you really think you could beat me as I am now? Fool. Ugh.
Starting off creepy to the max. And, Link is gonna have a big life change here. It's not puberty. It's something else. He's gonna go through a change with his body. Oh, no. So, yeah, another little nod to Ocarina of Time. The Deku Scrubs are actually very important in this. And that's one thing I like about this game as well, is a lot of the different little races and creatures from Hyrule get more fleshed out in this. Ugh. So creepy. They're cute, but they're creepy at the same time. Nice little dichotomy there. And if you didn't notice already, Link is looking pretty different. He's adorable. Aww. Even his little scream is now a Deku Scrub scream.
Hee hee, now that's a good look for you. You'll stay here forever that way.
Alright. And I don't know if we can catch up to him, but we're gonna try with our little wooden arms. Man, these fairies are mean. First they trick us off our horse, then they're smacking us in the face. Really kicking us while we're down.
Sis!
And, uh-oh. The fairies are separated. I don't feel bad for her, though. She just smacked me in the face. Link's got some nice bangs now.
Whoa, Skull Kid, wait for me. I'm still here. Tail, you can't leave without me.
These are the fairies, Tattle and Tail. Little puns with their names there.
You. If I wasn't dealing with you, I wouldn't have gotten separated from my brother. Well, don't just sit there, Deku boy. Do something. Why are you looking at me like that? What, is there something stuck on my face? Will you stop staring and just open that door for me? Please, come on, a helpless little girl is asking you, so hurry up. Oh, Tail, I wonder if that child will be alright on his own.
So Tail's the younger brother, I guess. So now we're a Deku Scrub, and we can do a cool little spin attack here, and also dive into these little flowers, and jump up, floating around. So we've got a few little unique abilities, but we're kind of weaker compared to Link would normally be. Whoa, jeez. We got some creepy... As if things weren't creepy enough, the bushes are even moving around. They're just, like, throwing a lot of things that you're accustomed to and comfortable with in Ocarina of Time. They're just throwing them right around and twisting them.
Hey, wait for me. Don't leave me behind. So, that stuff back there. I apologize. So take me with you. You want to know about that Skull Kid who just ran off, right? Well, I just so happen to have an idea of where he might be going. Take me with you and I'll help you out. Deal? Please?
I guess we don't have a choice. We need to lock onto stuff.
Good, so then it's settled. Now then, I'll be your partner, at least until we catch that Skull Kid. My name's Tattle, so, it's nice to meet you, or whatever. Now that we've got all that straightened out, can we stop messing around and get moving?
If I figure something out, press sideways on the control pad, and I'll tell it to you. Hopefully you'll manage to get by without my help until then. So, just like Navi in Ocarina of Time, Link's like, well, I don't know, did a little camera look. Like the office or something. So Tattle will tell us little hints about things and help us lock on stuff with Z-targeting, just like Navi could. She's going to tell us about those little Deku flowers there, but we know how to do that. Now, one thing I noticed in this, like, look when he spins. I don't think he actually had that weird, like, spiky thing come out of his hat. I think it's, like, his... Yeah, he also can do this. This is his shield. He, like, hides in a weird little Deku nut thing. But yeah, I don't remember him having a little spike on the end of his hat. I wonder if they're trying to make it a little more clear that's how he attacks when he spins around. But yeah, usually he just smacked people with his giant hat. It's also nice that my clothes transformed with me, so that's pretty handy. Otherwise, my hat would be too small for my giant Deku head. So there we go. We got some Deku nuts. And we can actually drop those to stun stuff and use them when we're in the air. Do you know how to use items? It's pretty important. Tap whatever that is, the little tab on the lower screen. Bring up item select. Yep, and we can assign them to buttons, and we can slide them around. So this is a little easier than most Zeldas, because you can just kind of do this while you're... Yeah, there we go. Just slide it over with the little touch screen, and we're good. So now I've got... I can actually put it... Oop, there we go. Didn't mean to use that. But we've got all these different buttons we can use here. Alright, so we're going to try to fly around. And now we can actually drop these Deku Nuts if we need to. Right now there's nothing to hit, but at least that's a form of attack for the little Deku Scrub. I feel bad for this little guy. It's your first form in this game, but it's a little tough to use and fight back when you're such a little tiny scrub. Hey you, come on, press L to talk to me. So we're gonna lock onto this and see what Tattle has to say about that creepy thing. There you go, see? You can do it if you try. When I fly over to people or objects, use L to look at them so you can interact with them. Use L targeting to talk to people, even if they're far away. Or if there's no one to target, you can just use L to look straight ahead. But enough about that for now. Come out over this tree and check it out. So, ooh, it's something that looks a little bit like me. And this will actually come up a little later. This is one of the creepy, kind of cryptic things in this game. Ugh, it's strange. But the way you look right now sort of reminds me of this tree. It looks all dark and gloomy, almost like it could start crying any second now. How sad. Alright, we'll come back to that later. But there's kind of a little secret plot about that. So I mentioned I played through this game before, but I'm going to try not to spoil stuff as we go along, and we'll have you guys experience it fresh if you've never played the game before. Twisting around, and now we're in this weird parallel universe for real now. Alright, creepiness going on here. And one of the other abilities of the scrub, you can see, you can actually hop on water. You can't swim or anything, so be very careful as the scrub, because you only get these little 5 hops, and if you don't manage to get across the water in that many moves, then you're just gonna sink like a stone, like a hopscotch stone. Alright, let's see if we can find our way through. Oh, hello! Ugh. I think these are little hint things. This is new for the 3D remake. Hi there, I'm a Sheikah Stone. Too soon, kid. Way too soon. Your journey's barely even started. Go on, get out of here. Scoot. Go have some big adventures. If you're stumped, come see me. I'll be happy to help. So yeah, those are kind of little hint things, but we don't need that. Oh, you've met with a terrible fate, haven't you? We got a new character here. He's also very important. Tattle's afraid of him. Not a good sign, because he's creepy. I just realized the fairies have kind of like bug wings there. I own the Happy Mask Shop. I travel far and wide in search of masks. During my travels, a very important mask was stolen from me by an imp in the woods. So here I am at a loss, and now I found you. Now, don't think me rude, but I have been following you. I love his little poses. For I know of a way to return you to your former self. If you can get back the precious item that was stolen from you, I will return you to normal. In exchange, all I ask is that you also get back my precious mask that the imp stole from me. He just, like, jumps into other poses. What? Is it not a simple task? Why, just someone like you, it should by no means be a difficult task. Except, the one thing is, I'm a very busy fellow, and I must leave this place in 3 days. How grateful I would be if you could bring it back to me before my time here is up. 3 days is very important. But yes, you'll be fine. I see you are young and have tremendous courage. I'm sure you'll find it right away. And if not, I'll strangle you. Oh, and one more thing. Please be so kind as to direct your gaze over there for a moment. What? Oh, he's going to explain the Sheikah Stone to us real quick. That strange stone over there, do you know it? It's called a Sheikah Stone. When the world has weighed you down with worry, crawl inside and let it show you the way. If ever you find yourself lost on your grand adventure, seek the counsel of this wise old stone that will surely help you on your noble quest. Looks like the truth mask there, too. Well then, I'm counting on you. Alright, you get a glimpse of Mario on his back there. He's got all these different masks, including a Mario one. So let's take our first step here into the main hub of the game. And now things have started. So the moon is going to fall in 3 days, and we have to find out how to keep that creepy thing up in the sky, where it belongs, before everyone and everything is destroyed in its wake. So this is Clock Town. This is going to be the center of our adventure, and there's a lot of stuff going on here over the 3 days that we have. He gives me the creeps. That mask salesman was the... Sorry, just thinking aloud. But 3 days, even if we never sleep, that still leaves us with a measly 72 hours. Talk about demanding. Well, don't just stand there. We're going to see the Great Fairy. Look, you want to find the Skull Kid, don't you? The Great Fairy will know what he's up to. She watches over everything. And just between you and me, the Skull Kid is no match for the Great Fairy. Pretty sure the Great Fairy lives in a shrine somewhere here in town. Where? Well, somewhere. Don't press me for details. I don't come to this town very often. You could try talking to one of those kids who hang out around town. One of them might know where the shrine is. Alright, so there's a little hint. Gotta look out for this dog, because I think he... Yep, yes. That dog, it doesn't do any damage, but that dog will interact with you different depending on what you look like. And for some reason, he hates scrubs. I feel bad for the Deku scrubs, because they're almost like second-class citizens in this world. They don't get any respect. Oop, something very important here. These are going to be how we save, and we can travel around with them as well. There we go. Let's save our progress at the owl statue. Now, one thing in this remake, it's actually a lot easier to save. You don't have to reset the 3-day cycle to be able to save. And there's another new thing. The bank has moved over here. It's a little more obvious. Jeez! run away from that dog. But yeah, the bank used to be, I think, in one of the side clock towns, like West Clock Town, but it's over here now, so it's a lot easier to see. There is a really creepy character that was introduced in this game. He's been in a lot of subsequent games, but he's right over here. Oh, jeez. I guess we ought to talk to him.
What's this? Green clothes, white fairy? Sir, could you by chance be a forest fairy? Oh, my. My name is Tingle. I think I am the same as you, sir, a forest fairy. Alas, though, I am already age 35. No fairy has come to me yet. My father tells me to grow up and act my age, but why? I tell you, Tingle is the very reincarnation of a fairy. Now, while I stand here waiting for a fairy of my own, I sell maps tell about my father. Lucky, lucky, you're so lucky to have a fairy. I know, we should be friends. Yes, yes, in exchange, I might sell you a map for cheap as a sign of my friendship. Will you buy one of Tingle's maps? I don't have... Oh, I do have enough. Okay, let's get a map of Clocktown.
Yippee!
Here we go. So now we can find our way around a little easier. The red arrow shows where we entered. Alright, so you have points of interest on the map there.
Oh, Tingle nearly forgot. Good sir, do you know how to use maps?
Tap on the map, yep, on the lower screen if we want to zoom in and out. There we go, we have our own map screen.
Well, call again.
Oh,
Tingle, Tingle, Kululimpa. These are the magic words that Tingle created himself. Don't steal them.
Tingle is so strange, but he is a really cool character. This is bizarre. He'll help us out by selling maps. And here is one of his little kids. Let's talk to him and figure out...
What do you want, shrimp? I'm busy practicing with my blowgun.
If you can pop that balloon, then don't mess with Jim. If you can't pop it.
Go on now, scram.
Ooh.
Who does that rascal think he is? He thinks he's so smart.
Whatever, let's not waste our time on the jokester. We need to visit the Great Fairy as quickly as possible. I know she lives somewhere nearby. And she is actually up here. So we're gonna go talk to her real quick. There we go. You can see all these flowers and hidden stuff around. There is a lot hidden in Clocktown, and a lot of people to talk to and meet. And we're going to do it over the course of the game as we try to stop that moon there.
Oh no, the Great Fairy!
So something's wrong with the Great Fairy here. She's turned into weird little kissy boo-boo fairies. Or something. Young one!
Please, hear my plea. I have been broken and shattered to pieces by the masked Skull Kid. Please find the one stray fairy lost in town and bring her to this fairy's fountain.
Aw, they'll heal us here. But yeah, these fairies look a lot different from the normal fairies. They are very strange looking. But they're kind of cute in a creepy way. And their weird little flappy ear wings or whatever on their head. Okay, so we're going to explore Clocktown a little bit more here. And we got to find that stray fairy if we want to make the Great Fairy whole again and have her help us. And that's something that will actually come up in dungeons and stuff later, too. Oh, we got another one of these creepy, mysterious grass parts where they move around. Also, there's a slide here if we want to have some fun. There's almost like a little playground going on. Let's check out another part of Clocktown as we explore. Headed back to South Clocktown is the main area here. Or no, this is one of the side ones, I think, here. Ooh. Tattle's like, hey, look at this! Look at this sign over here! The East Clocktown, there we go. The fairy, your little fairy guide, is going to fly around to different signs and you can target at them to check stuff. Mayor's official residence. So if you want to meet the mayor, he's there. There's a little kid over here as well. What's up, little guy? We've got a different bandana.
If you want to pass through here, you have to say the secret code.
We don't know that. If you're not a member, we won't teach you the secret code. If you want to be a member, go see Jim in North Clocktown. So we actually just met Jim, but he wants us to pop that balloon. A very intense test of your worth if you want to try to join this little gang of children.
Bomber's Bulletin Board. Become a Bomber's Notebook Expert. After all, notebook skills mean adventure skills. If you come across an event or hear anything juicy from other bombers, jot it down in your notebook.
Alright, so we can kind of look at little events and learn about the characters. And that's a big thing in this. Because we have these 3 days that we have to go around town, we need to be careful and kind of track what a lot of the characters are doing. There's a bunch of characters that are so weird and interesting in this, and if we happen to... you know, help out some of them, then maybe we'll get some good rewards. So we want to keep track of what they're doing.
That Skull Cat has gone too far. We can't just let that happen.
All right, so we're looking for the Great Fairy. Look at the time. We don't even have 3 days yet. So down at the bottom of the screen, you can see there's a little meter there. and that is showing the time. When 3 days are up, the moon, which if we can find a good spot here, I could probably look up and see if we can find the moon. It should be up in the sky somewhere. There it is. Look at that creepy thing. It's like it looks like a trip to the moon, that one old black and white film. There was the moon was so creepy with that face. I think that was influenced, was influenced by that. But we gotta stop that moon. But first, we really do need to find that little thing that is important to us. So we're gonna take a look around, and I think this little side area here is pretty important. I know where to head in some. Normally, you would just talk to some of the people and explore the town to figure out where you need to go. But we can speed things up a little bit. There we go, over here. This little curiosity. We're at the back of the curiosity shop. And there's like a little washing laundry area here. Gotta be careful. But if we hop across, we should be able to. There we go.
Please, hear my plea. The mask skull kid has broken me apart and scattered my pieces. Please find a way to return me to the Fairy Fountain in North Clocktown.
So we're gonna head over there. There's some nice little fishes in the water there, fishies. And there's a frog here. Hello. You actually can't talk to frogs. You don't want to talk to frogs because a lot of them are strangers and they will try to steal your bugs and eat them. No. The frogs, all these little guys, all these characters are important for one reason or another. We just got to figure out how we're going to interact with a lot of them. So we're going to head back over to North Clocktown. Let's put that fairy back together and get a little bit of help. So yeah, this first 3-day cycle, you can't really do anything to slow down time. Now, a lot of people get stressed out by this game because you have that 3-day limit, but there's a lot of ways to slow it down. I don't think it's that big of a deal, but it has turned off a lot of people from trying the game. So even if you're too stressed out to try to play, you can watch, and don't worry, I'm not stressed by the clock. There's ways to get around it and make it easier. But it is a kind of cool little framing for the game that shows you have a bit of a time limit on how long you can spend dilly-dallying around. You gotta get down to business and kind of map out what you think you can accomplish. But this first cycle, we can't do anything to slow it down or change it, really. So we gotta kind of power through and try to figure things out. Hello. Ugh, the great fairies are so creepy. But she's gonna help us, so we shouldn't judge.
Tattle, and you, young one of the altered shape, thank you for returning my broken and shattered body to normal. I'm the great fairy of magic. I thought that masked child was helping me, and I grew careless. All I can offer you now is this. I shall grant you magic power as a sign of my gratitude. Please accept it.
Here we go. She's gonna give us a little magical kiss, sort of, or something. Looks like a shower. I don't know where it's coming from, but whoa! Uh-oh. We're getting dazed here. What did she put in that magic? Oh. So now that we've acquired something new, we should be able to progress here pretty easily. Ha! Little fanfare for getting a new thing. We got magic power, so now we can blow bubbles of all things out of our weird little snoot. So we can aim around, and we need magic jars to replenish it. The man who lives in the observatory outside of town may know of the school kid's whereabouts, but be careful. You must not underestimate that child's power, kind young one. If ever you return to your former shape, come see me. I shall give you more help.
The fact that she, like, maniacally screams and laughs as she goes away, it makes me think that she could be some type of secret villain, but the great fairies are always helpful. For whatever reason, fairies like to help out heroes and use their healing power, so she's good. All right, so now that we have this, we can actually do this little, and we can use the gyro to do this now. We can also, there we go. Wrong balloon, but we did shoot down Tingle, so if we ever need to get Tingle, that's how we're gonna do it. So we can kinda aim this with the gyro or the control stick. It's kinda actually easier to aim using this, moving the system around. There we go, and we hit that. Hello, Jim. What's going on, buddy? Tingle's going back in the sky. How do you power that up? With farts or something? Alright.
Are you the one who just popped that up there? Not bad for a Deku scrub. We bombers have a hideout that leads to the observatory outside town. You need to code to get in. Maybe I'll tell you what it is. But don't think you're getting it that easily. I can't just tell you what the code is. You'll have to pass my test first. Are you ready?
Alright, line up, guys. So all the bombers are gathering, except for the little one guarding the door to the observatory. The five of us will run and hide in different places all over town. If you can catch all of us before sunrise, we'll teach you the secret code. Oh, and Deku nuts aren't fair game. They're bright and hurt our eyes, so you can't use them, okay? Got it? Alright, are you ready?
The one's a little slow. Aww,
he fell in his tiny fanny. Alright,
So we have to find all those bombers before sunrise, but luckily it's not too late in the day here. Alright, so I'm going to try to hit... I think there's one over here. Yep, I can see him already. I gotta try to catch them all here. Hello. I gotcha. Jim did not go very far. Oh, you caught me. There's only four left. Jim, for being the leader, he's not the brightest. He did like an Animal Crossing hide-and-seek where he's just like 5 feet from his house, hiding behind a bush or something where he's super obvious. Alright, so we ran into a few of the bombers as we explored town, and we should be able to catch up to most of them. If you guys watched me play Ocarina of Time, or Wind Waker HD, you saw me do a little bit of hide-and-seek in that game as well, and I think there is... We have to go on top of here, maybe? There's a way to get up, and there he is. He's on the ledge. And if we can get up to him... There we go. We can use the Deku Flower, or we can go into that little hotel there. You just saw a Goron walk over. That Goron's actually an important character, so we're going to have to see if we can go talk to him later as well. Tattle, I'm playing hide-and-seek. Bother me later. Let's ring that bell. There we go. Get him, get him, get him! These guys can be really fast. They gotta be quick. I think he already jumped off. Where'd he go? Where is he? Oh, he's still hiding over here near the bell. He just kinda ran around in a circle. Come here! I gotcha. Alright. Oh, you caught me! There's only three left. Smacked him with my weird little spiky Deku whatever thing that comes out of my hat. Alright. So that's one there. I think there's like one in each part of Clock Town. Although one of them might have two, because there's only four major parts of Clock Town and then the little laundry pool. There we go. Alright. See if we can find the one. There should be one over here, I think. See, it's been so long since I've played. I gotta remember some of this stuff. But it's kind of like riding a bike, where a lot of these memories come back to you pretty quickly. Uh-oh. Ominous sound. That means it's almost nightfall here. We've already used up half of the first day. And this is the last area we haven't headed to yet. This is... Oh, there's a bomber wandering around. West Clock Town. There's a lot of shops and different important places here. So if I can catch this guy before night falls. There we go. Two left. And I'm trying to remember where the other two are. But they shouldn't be too tough to find. Again, a lot of the bombers, not that great at hiding. Kind of just wander around. Night of the first day, so there's only 60 hours remain. That's how fast the clock goes normally. And you can actually speed it up and make it go faster or slow it down, like I mentioned. But we don't have the ability to do that yet, so I'm going to have to try my best. Whoa, wait, hang on. Oh, jeez. Trying to jack this Deku Flower from this guy, and he is not having it. Hello, fellow scrub. I am totally a scrub, just like you. This is my private property. Don't try using it when I'm not around. All right. So that guy is not letting me use that Deku Flower. There was a heart piece up there on the little spot, if you guys saw the near the clock. So I wanted to get that, but I don't think he's going to let me. This is east or west. I don't remember. We're going to see if we can find the other little guys. Yeah, west. There's something creepy going on here. There's a weird little dance. And we'll get back to this later.
Don't bother us.
Yeah, there's so many things. That's probably, like I mentioned, the characters are really unique and interesting in this because a lot of them have kind of dark backstories or different, you know, weird thick quirks to them. But the thing that I really like about this game is that because of there's actually like a time limit going on, it means that a lot of stuff can actually happen, and a lot of characters will have different events that they do during the day. You have to kind of keep track of what everyone is up to and try to follow them around. All right, I'm going to find those other bombers here. Hey, little guy. I just smacked him and he was in a box. So yeah, one was hiding in the laundry pool near this guy. Hey, aw, he looks so happy just to play his weird little thing. La la la, they said I was too loud when I practiced in my room. They got mad. Now I'm mad. I'll just stay here all night, away from their pad. And you are a child, so you must go to bed. He's doing some rhyming and stuff. Alright, there's only one more bomber to find. Hey, did they do some graffiti? Yeah, look, it's the bombers. And a little dog or a horse? Maybe that's the dog that runs around the plaza. Oh, hey, Tattle, what's up? Oh, why do we have to play these stupid brats little game? Come on, hurry up and find them already. Only eight? Okay. Oh, we only have a few hours till morning. We gotta find the last one. There you are, hiding in a box. Ah, no way, you finally got me. All right. So yeah, a couple of them were just hiding in boxes. I guess that's better than I didn't find them for a little bit, so it was a good spot. You're pretty good for a Deku scrub. If only you were human. They could give you an original bomber's notebook and make you a member. What do you guys think? No way, no scrubs! Don't want no scrubs. I guess not. Once we let some kid who wasn't human join our gang, and boy,
Did we ever regret it? Sorry. But I'll teach you the code, just like I promised. I can tell you only once, though, so pay close attention. Are you ready?
Alright. They have numbers on their back, so this is actually, I think, there's a couple different versions of this. So you have to be careful, and you can guess it without playing hide-and-seek, I think. 4-1-3-2-5, but you have to try a couple different combos, so I don't think you have to play hide-and-seek, but it couldn't hoit. It takes up a little bit of time to play, but I think over here is East Clock Town. This is where we want to go, I believe. Yep, there we go. Gotta remember to use my little map there until I'm reacquainted with everything. Here we go. So now we can go talk to this little guy, and we can get through, pass through, and I believe I already almost forgot it, but I think it was 4-1-3-2-5?
Oh, that's right. If you know the code, then you're a member, right? Okay, here you go.
Just slowly sidling out of the way. Bloop, bloop, his little squeaky shoes.
There's lots of cool stuff at that telescope guy's place. Oh yeah, and the Bomber Secret Society of Justice Forever.
Okay. So we're going to head... Actually, we're going to do that next time. I'm going to go save at the owl statue, but next time we're going to head to the observatory and try to solve the case of the scrub transformation and get back to being normal Link next time on Majora's Mask. So thank you guys for watching. Please leave a like if you enjoyed this. And remember, whenever there is a meeting, a parting is sure to follow. However, that parting need not last forever. Whether a parting be forever or merely for a short time, that is up to you, and I hope to see you guys next time for some more Majora's Mask 3D. Goodbye.